It's almost time to dust off the ice fishing gear, and some of you may already have. To kick off the ice season, I wanted to share some footage I had left over from last year that's too good not to share. My wife Stephanie and I were fishing in Madison, Wisconsin, on Monona Bay in a spot known as the Triangle. This busy yet easily accessible spot is known for big bluegills and limits all season long. Sit back and enjoy this episode brought to you by Peterson Outdoor Films. If you haven't already, please subscribe and hit that thumbs up button. We really appreciate it. Oh yeah, one last thing I should mention. Make sure to watch until the end. You don't want to miss out on this amazing drone footage I captured on that day out. Good morning and welcome back to the channel. Today we're going on an ice fishing adventure. This is my wife Stephanie. We're on Monona Bay. We're in an area called the Triangle. It's a fantastic bluegill spot. Some of you may be familiar with the spot, and if not, that's okay. I'm actually going to drop a pin on a map for you to see exactly where I'm at. This is called the Triangle, and this is a fantastic bluegill spot where you could bring a kid, sit on one hole, and they could probably catch 20, 30, 50 fish. It's nonstop action. It is mid-January right now with a high of about 34 to 36 degrees, low winds, so this should be a great mid-January fishing experience. What do you think? Are you excited?
Super excited. My one time in all season that I'm probably gonna get out, so I'm excited to get some fish on the ice.
The ice is deteriorating very quickly, so we wanted to get out here and fish one more time. Hopefully not the last time of the season, but it could be. This is a really weird winter, as most of you know. Guys, if you're new to the channel, please subscribe. We have tons of new content always coming out. I have some pretty neat videos that I filmed previously with underwater footage. We added a drone, so lots of cool things coming. All right, let's catch some fish.
Oh, there's a bunch of them coming in.
Bring it up, there you go. So you wanna watch the camera? Fish right here, in front of the camera. He's got it. Nice.
Oh my God.
That's all right. Good job.
That's crazy.
Makes fishing a lot more fun, does it
so
not?
So just stop it right
there? Yeah, there's the fish. Look at the ice. He was racing up at it. It's a little one. And sometimes too, if it's a little one, you can kind of try and get it away from him and wait for a better one. Like that one right there looks like a better one.
Come on, buddy. Pull up.
Just there. When they pull it in that second time, that's when you hook them. They always do that. Nice job. That is a keeper. Way to go. Look at that. Big gills. That was super cool with the underwater footage.
That was so cool.
The water is so clear right now. You just drop it down in between the weeds. You just find an opening and they just swarm it. I mean, the gills are stacked in here. This is amazing. I love this spot. I feel like we shouldn't fish unless it's on the camera, right?
We can take turns. I cannot get this. Ow.
How cool is that?
Should I keep this one?
Yep.
Nope. Whoa.
Jump back out of the hole. No, dude, you want to go the other way. You want to go in the hole. Goodbye.
Should I go?
Go for it.
Well, I wonder. I mean, you could probably spin it and just see it on the other side too.
Nope. You're in the perfect spot. We only need really one of us to be visible.
So many
There's
of them.
So many of them.
Danny.
Here he comes, he's racing in. Wait till that second bite. Give it the slack. Okay, I think he's got it. Go for it. Nice job. That's a good one too.
Is it?
Yeah, that's a
good one. Whoa! Okay.
Well, I mean, it depends how picky and choosy we want to be.
You.
Should we keep going for bigger ones? Or
is he gonna die now because he hit the ice?
No.
Then put him back in. Okay, you can go.
You know what? You just keep fishing there.
I'm sure.
Yeah, there's so many down there. So many down there. It doesn't even matter. So Stephanie's gonna be fishing. Is it foggy? Steph's going to be fishing in front of the underwater camera, and then I'm fishing about 3 to 4 feet over to the left of her. We're keeping fish today, so there you go. I think that's a keeper.
She seems a little bit heavier.
Yeah, that's a good one.
Okay, all right.
Try and get a double. Raise it up a little bit so they can see it. Yep, there you go. Now see that one coming in from the back.
Mm-hmm. He was coming and then he stopped.
Mm-hmm, because it dropped too low. He lost track of it.
Two of them.
Oh yeah, they're racing. Nice. Looked like a good one.
Let's see. Not bad.
Yeah, not bad.
Oh, don't hook me this time.
Nicely done. Fish in the frying pan, right?
Or the freezer.
Or the freezer, yeah. Mm-hmm. crazy. Jigging right next to him, and it's like he's not interested.
Come on back, guys. Where are you going?
There you go. Almost coming in for the kill. Must be in like a really thick weed spot over here because I'm not getting any bites.
No. You could try spinning the camera. It seems okay. Like they're turned off now. Look at that one just sitting there.
That's true. That could be the case. Interesting.
Should I put it in front of your face?
Sometimes you can drop it down a little bit and then bring it back up. It'll like entice them.
Swimming past it.
Yeah.
All of a sudden.
They're coming in to look. There you go. Let them do that double bite. Whatever you call it. There you go. Good job. That's a good one. Oh, that's a slop, Steph. Oh, yeah. It's a tank. Tank. Nice job, babe. Wow.
That's a good one.
That is a good one. Way to go.
I lost a wormy, I think.
Did ya?
Do I need to pull another one out?
Yeah, I think two is better.
Do you want to drop down in this hole?
I won't say what I want to say. Keep fishing. Catch them.
Sure?
Catch them. You don't get to do this nearly as often as I do.
There's so much falling right now.
Yeah, there is. Well, I'm on.
Nice.
Does not feel very big. No, it is not.
Hey, it's still a bit of action.
I guess. Little guy, going back. See ya. At least I know I can catch fish out of this hole. Feels decent. Feels like a good one. Oh yeah.
Oh!
I got him! Yes!
I can't believe that just happened.
It's a good one too. Oh my gosh. How did that thing not get away just now?
Oh, I'm on! Just got it! No, oh. You dropped it. Come on back, buddy.
I thought for sure that thing was a goner.
That is hilarious. Did you get that on your GoPro?
I think so.
We're bare hand fishing over here.
Looks like a, yeah, it's a good one. Yes. Sweet.
Not a bad one. We'll take it. Oh, now they're coming back.
Yep, just like that. It seems like they're hungry again.
Does like noise on the ice affect them?
Sure. I mean, it doesn't seem like it based on what I'm seeing here, but it can definitely spook them. Glad we brought the tent.
Yeah.
Or we'd be sitting out in the rain right now.
Didn't realize it was supposed to rain.
No, there was none in the forecast.
Oh,
it's in the weeds. This one feels decent, but I think I'm down in the weeds
now. Come on, babe, double bubble.
Come on. Come on, get out of there. Oh, no. He's way down in the weeds or something. What is going on?
Little dude.
Wow. This is a big fish. I don't know if this is bluegill.
Hey, what's that movie? Are their side fins pokey?
How is this a bluegill? Better, I am just wrapped in the weeds really bad. No, not too bad. Wow. Come on. There we go.
Yay, not bad.
I was all wrapped in the weeds. This thing, this fish did not want to relent.
He knew.
Yeah.
Make you work for it.
Valiant effort, but I gotcha. We're going in the bucket.
I feel like I want that Christina Aguilera song to play. Come on, help the baby.
I thought for sure I was gonna snap my line on that.
Really?
Yeah.
It's like all of a sudden no fish.
I may have stirred it up pretty good, pulling that out of the weeds. Yeah, I'm like right on top of a weed.
Do you see that?
Oh yeah. Oh, interesting.
What is that? Is that a minnow?
No, that's some sort of grub. That's probably stuff that they eat. That could also be a reason they're in here, because there's a lot of food.
Don't worry, dude.
I'm going to drop down here if you don't mind.
I don't.
Who wants it? Here we go. They're all coming in now. It's a decent kill. Come on, buddy. Take it.
I cannot get it. Can I throw it in your hole?
Mm-hmm. I think that was the fish I was trying to get, and he's swimming away. It could be a crappie, though.
Looks like a crappie.
It sure looks like a crappie.
Come on back, dude. Oh, we got a bite. Oh, we got one. Fish on. There you go. Oh, this is a good one. This is a keeper. This might be my biggest one today. Definitely a good fish. Thanks, little dude. Alright, let's drop it back down and see if we can get another. Here comes another one. Maybe not quite as big, but still a fish on. Okay, you're gonna go back.
What's up?
I can't get it off.
Okay.
I can't even see where it's hooked. nice.
That guy left. He's like, fish this one off. 75 out of here.
75?
Yeah. That's a throwback. Nice job, though.
I got another one, probably my biggest one of the day.
You did?
Yeah, that one got me right in between my fingers.
And it's in the bucket?
Yeah.
Nice. Snapped my jig at the hole and I had to reach in again. But the metal actually broke in its mouth.
That's crazy.
That sucks, so I gotta tie another jig on, and that's my good wonder bread. All tricky. Was it a good one?
I mean, it was a keeper. It wasn't huge.
It happens.
That's why I feel like I should put my glove on so it's not gonna like cut me and then I'm not like afraid.
Do you want your glove on?
I can get it out of the thing.
Yeah. I don't know. I feel like it would help.
That has happened to me.
But these things are so tiny, it's like hard to get a grip on them.
Mm-hmm.
Hear me? I feel like I probably sound like an idiot.
No, I just heard you laughing, so I was like, I gotta go see what's going on.
To it all of a sudden.
What are you gonna do?
Besides keep trying. There was a huge fish that swam by in the background.
Really?
Yeah.
Interesting.
And now they're not biting all of a sudden.
Like, maybe as a northern? Could have spooked them out of there.
No, it wasn't long. Like, it was longer than these bluegills.
Okay.
But it almost looked more like a walleye. Would those be in here?
Oh, yeah. We'll have to review the footage and check it out.
Any more luck out there?
They kept biting the tail, but they're not inhaling it, so I'm gonna switch to this.
Oh, this guy came in out of nowhere. And take it, yeah. Just a little guy. But for a little though, we'll take it. Oh, Grace, dude, you're gonna go back and grow. You when they're that little. Let's see if we can't get another. Interest here. And we got one. Hey, that's a keeper. Maybe. And some weights. We're gonna toss this guy back. While I've got no fish on the screen, let's talk about what I'm fishing with. The Frostbite Pantastick T29UL. So far it's been really great. I know Jake fishes with a different frostbite and he's really loved it. He was actually hoping to get another one of what he has for me coming along today, but they were sold out. So we decided to give this one a shot, and so far I think we've both been happy. On that note, we have a fish coming in. Hooked up, guys, hooked up. Another little guy. Huh? Just a little one. Tosser. Oh yeah, that's a nice one. That's a nice one, it looks like. Oh yeah. Much better. Today it's pretty crazy how many people are in such a small area, and I mean the guy that was right next to us said he caught 75 fish, and so everybody has a bit of luck, which is nice. Got it. He feels like a good one. Oh yeah, that's a great one. This is a slob, guys. Can't even freaking hold him. Super awkward way to show you guys this big guy, but were keeping them for sure.
Going in there.
Good.
We're with the UW Mass fishing team. We have an ice tournament going on over here at Pretty Hand Boats. We have a Vexler, Strike Master 24 bolt auger, and a clam shack that are getting auctioned off here. So we're just wondering if you wanted any tickets.
Do you have to be present to win?
No. We'll take your name, your number, and then we'll call you.
How much are they?
5 for 1 and 5 for 1 and 5 for 20.
Yeah, let me.
You
know what though? I don't know. Oh, I do. Yeah, I got my wallet. Hold on, let me get some cash.
We also take time
off. Oh, really?
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about.
What's your YouTube channel?
It's called Peterson Outdoor Films.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice.
We're pretty small, but like, I'm trying to make some like good quality videos this year, like fly the drone and everything.
Oh, really?
So I actually brought the drone. I was gonna fly it today.
Really?
This
would
be
so dope out here. So the only thing is like right here is a no fly zone, but like but it's like split in half, so I can actually fly it on this side.
Oh, okay.
And just pan and just
really?
You know, yeah.
Because
like the Dayton airport.
Oh, yeah.
But like literally, this is split in half where I can and can't fly. So. Let me get my wallet out, guys.
Getting some gills in there?
Oh, man. Who isn't?
Oh, nice. I didn't even see that.
Yes, yeah, so peek your head in here. We got an Aqua-Vu going.
Oh, that's sick.
See, look, there's one. Oh, they're coming in right now. You can... Oh, yeah. You're on. You can see so good down there. It's amazing. That is awesome.
You see any, like, big ones? Really big ones rolling?
Yeah,
crappies?
We actually did just see a crappie.
Really?
But it wasn't interested.
Those weeds are still super green. Wow.
We'll take two.
Absolutely.
All right, cool.
Yeah, I have not. I did a YouTube channel. I was called Wisconsin Anglers for a while, too.
I've heard of that.
Have you?
But you don't do it anymore?
Well, I went to college, and now I'm at UW, and my buddy kind of runs it with me, Tony Cass.
Okay.
He kind of took it over while I'm at college. I'm not really on the filming side of things, but during the summer, I definitely fish.
Yeah.
I still kind of do it, but yeah, it's good stuff. I love documenting.
Here, I'll give you a sticker. That way you can remember us.
Oh, cool. Yeah, I'll definitely make sure to subscribe.
I mean, there's two of you guys in each one. I mean, like I said, we're pretty small. We have like 1,500 subscribers. We are monetized, though.
Nice.
But like,
cool logo. Hell yeah.
But like I said, like this year I've really started to focus on like much better quality videos. Like some of our older shit's pretty lame. You know, like you're like a robot in front of the camera.
Yeah. Are you doing videotaping underwater footage?
Yeah, that is recording actually. I got an Avermedia device recording it right now.
Nice.
Oh really?
All right. So I bought
your
two.
Name,
so
or first name, last initial, and a number. That's all.
I guess he's throwing a bonus for you.
Oh. You gave me three. You want one back?
Man, there's so many fish in the system.
Oh, this is crazy.
Are they just rolling?
Like,
through?
Look, and he's got the camera set up.
Peek your head in here.
Oh yeah! Wow. I mean, there's some guys out here with these big cane rods, just one after the other.
Oh wow!
Like their line's not even down. I guess they're not cane rods, but they're like four.
Do you think some guys have six hitters?
That guy over there does.
Yeah.
He does. I could watch that footage all day long.
I know. Well, if you check back to the channel, you'll be able to see it.
For sure.
We'll check it out.
So do you primarily fish in like the Madison area then? Or?
I've been all over. Honestly, I was up in Mosinee, Early Ice. We're from Beaver Dam, so I fish Beaver Dam.
Nice.
She's on. Fox Lake, that's a good one. Oh man,
yeah.
Slab.
This is probably my biggest of the day then.
My wife's killing them, man. I'm just letting her catch the fish.
Well, sometimes that's the way it goes.
You guys said you have a tournament going on out here?
Yeah.
So how does that work? Do you guys like fish against other schools?
Well, today most of us aren't fishing it. It's kind of just ran by the board members, so general team members will fish it, but it's just everyone out here versus everyone else today. It's just basically like a longest fish wins type of thing.
Oh, okay. So
there's a bluegill and a crappie division. But yes, normally, like on open water, us as a school team will fish against, you know, Platteville or Stevens Point or
whatever.
Not to enter your address or anything. Just the
name, I don't,
just
okay.
The name and number, because we'll just call you.
So, yeah, if you guys end up running into a big bluegill or a nice crappie, just swing by and register it. So.
You don't have to, like, register ahead of time?
I don't know. We've kind of been a little free with it just because people, for whatever reason, they haven't really been signing up, but they've been out. I mean, we're going to have a come-up. It'll probably be around 11. That'll be that for registrations. But.
Okay. What's do you know what the biggest gill is right now?
9 5/8.
That was the last time we were back, and that was
the biggest I don't know.
Really?
Yeah. Where do you go to register?
It's over at the boathouse, so it's right off the main Monona Bay, right across the bridge.
If you wanted to register now, we could also register now and put it in the spreadsheet. That way, you don't have to walk over.
I mean, we definitely don't have a gill that big, so yeah. I'm not sure if it's worth it.
Well, we'll be walking around out here. We're over at Bernie Hamble, so
okay.
Stop over.
Awesome.
Okay. Yeah, I'll just give you a call so you don't have to.
Cool.
Yeah. Thanks.
Thanks, guys.
Check out the channel too.
Yeah, please do. I'll fly the drone here in a little bit. You'll see it.
Hell yeah. That'll be awesome. Hey.
It's sick, man.
Yeah.
Oh, it's brand new, so. All right, guys.
Okay.
Thank you. Later.
They keep like doing that first bite, and then for the second bite, they spit it out.
Take it. Yes! That's a good looking gill.
Hell yeah.
That's a dandy.
It's no 9 5/8, but we'll take it.
Dang.
Okay, stop splashing
water.
Yeah, eh? Oh yeah, guys. That's a good one.
That is a good one right there.
Do you want to drop a line in?
No, go for it. Okay, let me skim your hole.
Oh, they're all coming in now.
Oh my god! Oh. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
Not to mention the ones like out of frame that you can't see.
Oh my god.
Yeah,
you're caught on the ice. There you go. It's down. It already went past the camera. Okay. Yeah. Oh. You're down in the weeds. Bring
no,
it up.
I just.
There we go. There was so many bluegills. That one in the back is big. Bring it up a little bit, jig it right there. That was a big gill.
They don't like that when you put it right in front of their face, do they? Tried to have been a couple times. Well, that one just darted.
Yeah, it was. There's so many. My god. Oh.
Coming in hot out of nowhere.
Coming in hot. That's too bad.
Yeah. But hey, it's a fish on your line.
It is a fish. Throwing that one back. That one came in hot. Well, should we wrap it up? We got a lot of fish.
I want to try one more time.
Okay. Do you want this?
Yeah.
All right, guys, that is a wrap. We got on the gills like crazy today, nonstop, one after another. She was sitting in front of the Aqua-Vu, the underwater camera, and had swarms of gills coming in nonstop. I don't know, what do you think? Was that fun?
It was awesome. It was super cool footage and obviously extra easy to see what I'm catching, when I'm catching. So definitely like that.
Yeah, that was sick. You did a great job. So yeah, we definitely have a bunch of fish to go home and clean, which I'm stoked about because we were running low. So now we've got fish for the frying pan and fish for the freezer. So guys, please check out the links below. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe. We're gonna have a ton of new content coming. I've got some pretty neat videos that I filmed previously. I've got some underwater footage of a muskie, some panfish, some crappies. So check that out and check back for more content. Thanks for watching.